Back in 2008, I was a student planning to go to university and needed some extracurricular stuff I could put on my entry applications. As most UK students know, one of the best things to have on there is the Duke of Edinburgh Award. As a part of this award, you have to embark on the orienteering expedition, basically a long trek through the woodlands and rural villages, following nothing but a map and a compass. No GPS allowed. It's a teamwork experience, and you camp and overcome hurdles together. Anyways, I was out of shape at the time, so my uncle volunteered to take me out in the middle of nowhere to get some idea of what it was like. We didn't stay out overnight like what I would have to during the real thing, but we hiked about 10 miles through woods and a small village in pretty abysmal weather. By the end of the journey, we were soaked to the bone and pretty miserable, looking forward to getting back to the car and heading home. For the last part of the journey, we were on a dirt hill heading uphill with bushes and trees on either side. We were marching onward in silence at this point when all of a sudden there was a rustling in the foliage to our left. From behind a large bush stepped an old man in a black suit with a red bow tie and dress shoes. He looked like 70s or early 80s, very pale, liver spots dotting his face with a gray-white comb over. I was instantly weirded out. Who dresses like that to go into the woods? The instant thought seeing a guy his age out there with those clothes in this weather condition was, this guy's lost his marbles. There was something else that took me an extra moment to notice, though, that puzzled me. The guy was bone dry, didn't even have mud on his shoes. We stopped in our tracks and just stared at the man for a moment, who appeared to be frozen and shocked at seeing us. My uncle made the first move, taking a step towards him, asking him if he was all right. The old man continued to stare for a moment, not moving even a twitch, then became suddenly very animated. It was like he suddenly snapped out of a trance. He started flailing his arms wildly, saying something awful had happened, that a good friend of his needed help. He began walking backwards into the woods, motioning for us to follow him, which we did. We started off at a brisk walk, then escalated to running as we were struggling to keep up with the old man. After maybe a minute, he disappeared ahead of us, but we could hear him, so we continued to follow the noises till we reached a huge slope. We stopped at the edge and looked down to see the old man standing there at the bottom, motioning us, pleading with us to follow him. I remember looking down at the slope. It was probably at a 40-degree angle and spanned for perhaps 50 feet or more and slick with mud. It looked like an accident waiting to happen, especially given that there were no shrubs or roots to hold onto or anything. I remember looking down at the old man on the other side of the slope and wondering, how the heck did he cross that so quickly and cleanly? I mean, at that distance, it's hard to see fine detail clearly, but I swear he still did not appear to be wet or muddy at all. Me and my uncle looked at each other, and I saw that he was as weirded out as I was. Despite my feelings, I made a step towards the edge and was going to try to make my way down when my uncle grabbed me firmly by the arm and pulled me back. Underneath his breath, he said, something's wrong here. We took a few steps back from the edge at this point, and the old man at the bottom started getting irate. He began pleading with us again to come down the slope, telling us he needed our help. His friend was in trouble. My uncle shouted down to the old man that we would head back to the car and call emergency services for him, that professional help would be on its way soon, that they would have the tools to get him. The old man suddenly got furious, began jumping up and down, demanding we came down the slope right now, or there would be hell to pay. His voice changed drastically. He was practically growling his words, his hands bunched up in fists, pounding his knees like an angry toddler throwing a tantrum. I've never seen a grown adult fly into such a rage in my life. His eyes looked like they were on the verge of bursting out of his sockets. His skin gone from pale to red almost in an instant. We began to hurriedly make our way back the way we came, his demand and threats getting less audible as we got closer to the trail. Once on the trail, we practically power marched the remaining quarter mile or so to the car. All the while, my uncle was on the phone with emergency services, explaining to them that there was possibly a mentally ill man wandering the trail. We were ordered to get to our car and wait for the police so we could show them where we had encountered him. About an hour later, we met four officers, two whom had dogs with them, and packs of supplies like first aid, emergency blankets, etc. We led them to the exact spot and then pointed to the two officers with dogs in the direction he led us through the bushes. The search lasted all weekend, but there was no trace of the old man. Officers said the only trail they could pick up was mine and my uncle's. They didn't find any footprints or anything belonging to the old man we encountered. One of my weirdest experiences to date.